from sickness. Oh, can I tell you about it? From diseases. Yes, it's a slow kill. Oh, the devil sometimes don't want to take you out right away. He wants to put you through the grand reaper. He wants to make sure that you're depressed. He wants to make sure that you cry. My God. He wants to make sure that that heart is truly broken. My God. But God, oh Jesus, he died on the cross. Oh, I'm jumping and skipping everywhere now.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
He died on the cross. Yes.
Yes.
And he died for sicknesses. Oh my God. So I claim my healing. He died for our diseases. My God. So any disease that the enemy meant to give me what he can and deposit his thing in my body, I am disease free in the name of Jesus. Oh, he died for your sicknesses, your sins. Oh my God, did you already give him your sins? He died for your sorrows. My God, have you been hurting? Have you been broken? Oh, what happened in your life lately? Did you lose a loved one? My God, he died for your sorrows. And he died. That's what my Bible tells me. He died for your griefs. Do you know what the griefs are? My God, even when the children cuss you out, it grieves your spirit. My God. Even when your spouse might get angry with you, oh, it grieves your spirit. My God, even when they talk about you, oh, they say all kinds of manner and evil about you, it grieves your spirit. Oh, you're so broken. Oh, you just gotta bend down on your knees and you gotta cry out to God. And it says, when you're broken and you cry out in worship, oh, you get a fresh anointing. Oh, let the pain work for you. Oh, let the pain work miracles for you. Oh, God, had me in a place where all I did was I stood like this and I had my back against the wall. And I said, what they said, my God, I love them. I still love them. Oh, in spite of, I still love them. Oh, worship you. Oh, forgive them, Lord. Why? Why me, Lord? Why did they have to do it to me? Why? What have I done, Lord? What have I done, Lord? I just wanted to love them, Lord. Much love to give. I just wanted to love them. That's all I wanted to do. To share. Oh my God. Oh, instead of receiving the love, they decided to trample all over me. But forgive them, Lord. They don't know what they did. But I said to every person who allowed the devil to use him against me.
Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Turn it around, Lord.
Thank you.
Hallelujah.
I said, thank you.
Jesus.
I said, thank you.
Thank you.
I said, thank you.
Thank you.
Because it allowed me to walk in my destiny. Because God said he had a plan for me. And I wanted to know what his for me, because I was making a living mess of myself, mess of his plans. So I say to every devil from the pits of hell who tried to take me out, thank you for the experience. anointing. I got life. My God, I receive an anointing. Every yoke of bondage that was on my back, hey, they fell off. They became broken. Oh, they fell off of my shoulders. My God, I don't know what you're going through. Lay it at the foot of the cross. He came to die for your sins, your sicknesses, your diseases, your sorrows, your griefs. My God, his body was broken. Oh my God, his body was bruised. My God, for everything that you are carrying. Now that you say you have a right to go and give it to Jesus. Let him be the burden bearer. Oh, you should be happy right now. Oh my God, when I see people looking sad, I've got to encourage them because better days are coming. Oh, he said the ladder is greater than the past. Do you believe that better days are coming? Oh yes. Oh, the word of God does not lie. Oh, it is same for yesterday, today, and forever. So I'm standing on the living word of God to know that I know that I know that I know that better days are coming. And I shall live, you shall live, and not die. The word of God tells me so.
Hallelujah.
So be encouraged. Remember, it's a process.
My God.
If you mess up one day, go right back to the cross.
Hallelujah.
Give it to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Repent. Yes. Hey, you're just starting out.
Yes.
You're not going to be perfect. The devil is going to come and test you. So remember, you have Jesus now.
Hallelujah.
Tell him you have a new life now.
Hallelujah.
Tell him you have a new Lord now. Tell him he's no longer your Lord. And you're going to say, Jesus, help me. I'm giving this to you. I repent again, Lord. It was one little thing, but I messed up. Forgive me. Help me now to keep on moving in this salvation walk. Father, baptize me by fire because I need your power to be able to do works, to be able to do signs, wonders, and miracles that you said, because greater works than these shall we do. Do you know that? Greater works than what Jesus did, you shall do. So you need the Holy Ghost to help you do the greater works. My God, I could go on, Pastor, but I don't want to be rude. My God, oh, I feel like they need a little bit of something more just to encourage them. My God, you're now in the place of Gilgal. You ever heard of that place called Gilgal? My God, in 2 Kings 2 verse 1, when Elijah connected with Elijah. Do you know Elijah was tormented?
Yes, he was.
By one of the biggest demons from hell. My God, that demon wanted to destroy the church body. My God, he went down there and Jezebel came up against the man of God. My God, I know I'm talking to somebody. Now that Jezebel spirit don't have to be a woman. It don't even have to be a man. It's a spirit. They have no sex. Amen. So I know that some have been through that. Jezebel spirit. You always want to do this. Oh, you always want to do that. And it feels so good. My God, I can't let go. I'm speaking truth. But it's not you. It is. I come here to let you know it is a spirit. My God. Oh, my God.
Some
of you have been down that road. Oh, Elijah said, my God, you know it's connected with the spirit of witchcraft. They work together. My God.